She's not enjoying her time here. She doesn't want to visit again, it seems. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up today? Got some things to talk about, we got some new things, but disclaimer, my brows, you know, I told you guys they're gonna be looking a little different. It took me forever to get them on my face right now, forever. And we'll get into why later on in the video, but new things, Persona Cosmetics came out with these contour sticks, these bronze multi-sticks. So we're gonna give those a go. We also have Bite Beauty's new blushes, super cute. There's like a dropper packaging situation. We'll see how they work on our skin, but for lips, I have the new NYX Lip Lingerie XXL, which is, you know, blowing up all over TikTok and the internet because this is supposed to be transfer proof and waterproof. We've never tested a waterproof lip on our channel, so very exciting, first time for everything. I also wanted to do some sort of like brown, deeper eye, this matte vibe that I was inspired by, just, you know, scrolling through my media. So that is our aim for the day, yay, yay. But first, we do have a brand partner, a supporter, a sponsor of this video, which is a brand I'm super familiar with if you've been watching any of my hair content within the last year and throughout the years, especially since I cut my hair short, then you already know I've mentioned this brand quite a bit, especially when it comes to their styling products. Our sponsor is Way, which is the brand created by celebrity hairstylist Jen Atkins. I live, breathe, swear, and would die by their texture spray. My hair has quite a bit in it right now, as well as some volumizing, you know, like the powder that you like sprinkle at your roots or you pump at your roots. That's what I've been using a lot lately since taking out my one row of extensions. I told you guys about it if you've been keeping up with my recent videos. So to boost that natural volume, since she's, you know, all natural right now, minus, you know, this color, I have been going a little harder on, you know, the dust, the powder dust, the products. And typically I don't like doing that too much. I don't want to build up gunk. I wash my hair once a week, so I got to be careful with how many times I heat style it, how many times I volumize with my products. And for the most part, I only do that twice a week during my 7-day wash period. Being that I go 7 days, which, you know, my hair has adjusted to, I have trained to, I do think every week I like to reset my hair, thus introducing their new shampoo, which I was very excited to try out. This is their detox shampoo. Love the size of the bottle, love the aesthetic, love the size of the bottle, love the price, love it all. This is a once a week treatment that features apple cider vinegar and keratin, so it exfoliates, it brightens your scalp, it helps smooth your frizz, and also just gives you a nice overall shine. So that's especially what your boo needs, because my scalp can get quite itchy. You know, I am a dandruffy, flaky gal, and now with my darker side, it's very apparent if I don't, you know, keep it clean. So I've tried this twice already. I don't need much at all. And overall, since I only wash, you know, once a week, the past 2 weeks, my scalp has felt so good. It feels clean right away, but it doesn't feel dry. And that would make things worse. Like whenever you overstrip anything, skin, hair, doesn't matter, it's not good for you. But this is a really great balance where I don't feel like it stings at all. I was a little nervous about the apple cider vinegar. No need to be nervous at all. It's very, very subtle. Like it doesn't smell weird. It has a beautiful fragrance, which has lychee in it, cedar wood, all things that I personally adore. It has a little bit of rose as well. And if you've ever smelled their Melrose fragrance, that's actually the scent of the shampoo. That's totally magical. The apple cider vinegar. The detox shampoo is good for all hair types. I follow it up with a hair mask of some sort. I always do. My hair needs that extra moisture and love. So they sent over the fine to medium hair treatment, which is probably one of the more tacky masks that I've ever tried. But I do like that because I feel like it holds onto the hair in the place that I want to. It doesn't slide right off. So that's really nice. And after I've towel dried my hair, I have been spraying the leave-in conditioner by Way as well. I always use some sort of like detangler or like blow dry primer or leave-in conditioner, because if I'm gonna go 7 days, adding the most moisture without being detrimental is ideal for my hair type. So overall, really great experience. I've tried their other shampoos in the past. They're like more repairing formulation and their volumizing formulation. But I haven't found a really good like clarifying detox treatment, and this is perfect for me because I was nervous, you know, with this lighter side of my hair, using anything too harsh might have been, you know, a cause for some breakage. But none of the above happened. Super happy about it. And they've also hooked me up with the 15% off promo code to give to y'all. So if you want to shop at theway.com, which is T-H-E SAMMAGE.com. You can use code SAMMAGE, which is my username, S3A's MMAGE. You get 15% off, boo. Go ahead, use it, save the coin. They are a cruelty-free brand, paraben-free, sulfate-free, so all of their hair care, body care, fragrance, you can shop with confidence that they don't have any of those things in it, and give them a go. I heard their hand cream is bomb.com, so that's the next thing on my radar. So make sure you save those coins. Now let's get into our application. So I'm gonna, you know, strap back our perfectly beautiful styled hair. So I think I want to pop on our eye look first, just because I think that will help me gauge how much intensity I should do with the rest of the product. So I'm going to be using the Juvia's Place Eye Primer. This is in shade 2. It's not super bright, and I've already kind of concealed under my brows, but if you wanted something lighter, there is definitely an shade 1. I've been using this, and I've really been liking it. A little bit goes a long way. I am wearing my Kiss Falsecera lashes again. I typically am, and this is the lengthening pack, like no wisp mixed in, just the lengthening. I'm kind of sad because whenever I apply first, which I do like to, just so I can shape my eye correctly, I do get like eyeshadow all over it. I'm gonna try my best not to gunk it up, but if you see me doing so, just look away. The palette of the day, Makeup by Mario Master Matte. I think she's just the most appropriate. I'm gonna start with, let's start with our brow bone, so the lightest color, number 1. So it goes 1 through 4, and then 5 through 8, and then 9 through 12. That's how the palette is numbered. So just applying that directly to the brow bone, and now we're gonna go for our crease shade, which I think I'm gonna mix a little bit of 2 and 4. Just blending this out towards our brow bone shade with a really light hand. I wanna make our lid the darker point of the day versus being the lighter point, a little intensity. And then I'm taking just number 2 and just blending the very, very outer edges because that's my perfect transition shade. She's so bomb. I am ready to just, you know, run some errands today. I'm actually meeting up with my sister, so we have to run some errands for our parentals. We're at that age, you know. I'm sure you guys can relate. I've been on here so long, it's weird to think that it's really been like, I'm like closer to 30, but when I started, I was like closer to 15, you know. That's a time. What shade for our lids today? I think I'm gonna try number, I'm really debating between 5 and 6. 5 and 6, 5 and 6. How about we actually just jump all the way to 8 and see if this is too warm? No, I like it. I like it, actually. While we're here packing this onto our lid, let me tell you guys about my brows. So, the brows, guys. It was quite painful, and they warned me at the laser place that it was gonna hurt. There's no numbing, and it was a B. And for those who are just like, why did you take off your microblading? We are switching up the shape a bit later on in the summer, so we were just removing some of the old strokes. But the thing is, the laser targets dark pigmentation. So they do say that if you can use a whiteout pen that they give you and, you know, mark an area you don't want taken off. But since I'm already there and the same cost per the whole brow, I knew I only mainly needed like half of it off. But for the most part, I was like, well, if I'm paying for the whole brow, I might as well get the whole brow done and get as fresh of a strokes later, as bare of a canvas as possible as I can bear, you know, no pun intended. So I said, you know, it's fine. But they did say, and this part shocked me, that your hair turns white. I was like, oh, so my hair will even be there? That was what I was betting on. I was like, all of my hair is gonna be there, but like blonde. So it is there, but you can't really see it like before. Like, you can't really see the texture of my hair. So it looks more solid than usual, which is kind of the look until the hair grows back. Some of it's already started to grow back, but you know, we got a long few weeks ahead of us, it seems. Ooh. I think we picked a good shade. You never know. So now I'm just kind of shaping our lid and trying to make sure I get the color, you know, all over. You can see there's like a little areas where I'll need to take a smaller brush to, but I'm just packing it on and blending the edge. The mattes look beautiful. I just want you to know you're my favorite palette. If you don't know that song, we cannot be friends. Or you may be just a little too young to be my friend. It's cool, it's cool. We might make some exceptions later. We'll see, we'll see. I'm in love, I'm in love. I don't know what else we're gonna be doing with this later. I feel like we need to be highlighting the inner corner of some sort, but we're gonna let it be for right now because I don't know. We're gonna see where the face goes. So next, I do have a little bit of a skin tint on mixed with like a drop or two of foundation. That's kind of our base. I'm not gonna tell you guys what it is because I'm kind of just testing it out for other purposes, but stay tuned and we'll talk about it a little bit later. I wanna conceal at the same time as I contour. So let's see these two shades. This is the Persona Cosmetics Bronze Multi Sticks. I think we're gonna be using the lighter shade. I'm very, very excited. Oh God. As always, I like nick it with my nail in the cap. First shade is Dune. Second shade is Sahara. They're both a little warmer because they are like bronzing versus contouring. I want to start off with the lighter shade and see how that looks on me. It feels very creamy just from the swatch. Exciting. So I'm applying Dune on the side of my nose and bringing it down. And I think I'm gonna try it directly on the face since it seems to be like super creamy. It's giving me the same consistency as the Huda Beauty stick foundation. I think I'm gonna want to curve this just a little bit. Maybe, I don't know. A lot of people are applying it straight, but it's not looking good on me straight. So we're gonna do what we know. That is shape our chin out a little. We're actually gonna bring this a little down like that. Oh. Can you get any more crazier looking? Maybe. I actually wanna put just a little bit of the darker shade in the center of my nose area to really, you know, help a buddy out, which is definitely more red on me, so not too much of that. Wipe off the swatches before we end up in a mess. And then for our under eye concealer highlight shade, I'm using 2.5N from Dior. This is a lighter shade, as you can see, and a very pigmented concealer, so I don't wanna do too much. Did we get it down the nose? We did. We kind of got it there. There we go. Might need more of that later. A little bit up here and then a little bit down here. Okay, next we're gonna try the Persona Cosmetics brush they have. I haven't actually used this much except for on blush. Here we go. Contour areas first, at least that's what I'm aiming for. It's blending into my hairline like very naturally. That's what I look like on the darker areas of my face. It hasn't dried out on us at all, which is beautiful. I might use the other side for the concealer. Might be a little too sparse for the concealer though. My earring is is kind of pushed against my skin. Gotta get in there, we gotta shape. Serve that side profile jawline. I'm blending upward. This side looks a little bit more intense. Moving that under eye concealer around and out. I know a lot of people like to put it right there, so there we are. I mean, I usually drag it. I guess you shouldn't say drag under other eyes. Will kill me, but I usually move it that direction anyway, and I like, you know, more slippery concealer, so typically it doesn't take much effort. So I'm blending my concealer downwards since I was trying to blend my bronzer upwards to meet each other. I saw that tip on TikTok recently, and I'm hoping it works well for me. We're almost there. I know it looks like really strong right here. I do plan on doing like a thin layer of my base on top after we get all of this settled in. Oh no, I kind of got my eyebrow. Oops. Just a little bit more on the center of the nose, just right there. All right, so now we just kind of need to, you see that like orangey hue that you can really see from the front? We need to kind of, you know, just tone that down a bit. This is a empty or, you know, dry brush. Nothing on it. I just want to make sure I'm kind of like pressing it into the skin with little tiny strokes. And then just a little bit of our base to kind of just help blend. For our blushes, we have two different shades. So we have Melon Mojito, which is a deeper shade, and then Coconut Rum. So, I feel like this might be cute and subtle, or them mixed together might be cute, but let's see. So it's a packaging where you twist off the top and you get a little dropper. There it is. This is actually the lighter shade, which is Coconut Rum. Oh, that's kind of cute. The consistency is a little interesting. It looked a little lumpy at first, and it's quite shimmery. So this is a whip blush, they say. So this darker shade, Melon Mojito, put it right next to it. It's a little bright for what we have going on. That's really bright. It's very watermelon colored. So now I'm gonna take a bit of Coconut Rum, warm it up on the back of my hands, and just press it in to the cheekbone. It feels actually kind of cold because it is a little moussey, but I guess the moussiness makes it quite forgiving as well. It has that shimmer, so it kind of gives us a little bit of a glow too. Granted, we haven't powdered at all, so that's just kind of what we look like. It's gonna use the bottom of a damp brush and kind of just press it into the skin and make sure it doesn't go too high up as it was on this side. Like highlights needed. Coming through with the e.l.f. Face Duo in White Peach highlight shade. Just towards the back. Same thing on the other side. I would like this on my chin as well, and then just the center of the nose bridge, which is gonna need something a little bit more precise. It's a little strong on the nose, but we'll go over it with our powder. So powder of the day, Colab. This is the Soft Focus Set Stage Powder. You guys know I love, love, love her, and she always comes through. So we're gonna grab a little bit of this and put it on, obviously. But right where we would want some brightness, some highlights. You see the big difference? It's not even fully pressed in on that side either, so. It gets better. I'm gonna use the same highlight on our face into my inner corner, just like that. So oddly enough, my nose is having a really weird foundation day. Like, it doesn't like what I'm trying or something like that, because even with primer, she's not enjoying her time here. She doesn't want to visit again, it seems. Luckily, we're not wear testing our face, so we're gonna ignore that. I'm gonna do a little mascara and then we're gonna do our lips. I can't get over the fact that my nose is so pissed. Like, it doesn't like it. I've tried three different bases. It's just not that day. But I do have the shade Turn On with the NYX Lip Lingerie. The applicator's a flexible doe foot. Okay. Pigment. It's a thin doe foot too. I like it. It has the like crevice in the middle that holds a lot of product, but it's really controlled. Uh-oh, we got a little carried away. So this lip product feels like a similar version to the Maybelline. God, what is it called? I'll put a picture right here. It's slipping my mind right now. It feels like that, but it's comfortable. Those last a really long time too. This has a really strong, like, vanilla birthday cake type of smell and taste to it. So it's drying down now. I think one coat is good enough. I don't think you'll need to layer with this product. This is ideal. I like that it's not super sticky. I don't want to rub my lips together until it's totally dry to really check the texture. But it feels very, very similar to the Maybelline. And it's not cracking or peeling. It claims to be 16-hour wear, transfer proof. It's supposed to be able to do it all. I'm basically locked and loaded. I haven't ate yet today, so I'm quite excited to see how that does. It says one swipe is full coverage, 24 shades, 100% vegan lip formulation, and it's supposed to be flexible that it doesn't crack or bleed or fade on you, just like your favorite shapewear for the lips. I don't think it says waterproof. I don't know. I felt like I imagined that, maybe. I don't know, but it is definitely transfer proof. We can dry water later, I guess. Isn't that the same thing as eating though, basically? Let's just drink some water. Let's see. Oh wait. What was that? Maybe that was excess product. Maybe that's what it's supposed to look like now. Okay, a little less. I'm running out of hands. Frying again, making sure this is really dry. Less, so I feel like you might have to blot off them. Now it doesn't look as hydrated though. It doesn't have like a glossy coat like their other product did, the dual-ended one, which we have also tested. I really like that product. All right, I'm trying to take a very, very small amount and touch up the inside just so it doesn't look like it's losing product there. I'm gonna let it fully dry before I eat any of my food. It's pretty much there, I guess. I wasn't expecting it for some reason. We're gonna be checking back in for a little mini end of the day result after at least a couple hours to see how this is holding up. And I'm back 6 hours later and a whole meal, bubble tea, boba later. I did reapply just a little bit. We'll get into it. Let me bring you guys in real close. As you can see, the color is still very opaque. It's still very comfortable too. I actually saw my sister. I was like, yo, touch my lips, like feel it. And she's like, oh, that feels really good. Like, it feels very natural. It feels like your natural lip. It doesn't rub off at all. Like nothing, you can see nothing. And nothing comes off. I think blotting is a little better in the beginning, and then reapplying anything that like comes off is great, because the amount of product that comes in that one coat pigmentation is possibly gonna give you more than you need on your lips. Or of course you could use like, you know, a different brush, or you know, be really careful with how much you apply. But naturally I think it applies a lot. I think the shade Turn On was quite accurate to the outside packaging. It looks really good, it feels really good, and overall I think it's very, very nice. Like, my lips are dry, and as you can see, like, it is like naturally gonna be a little peely, but it's not a problem, because I mean, in other lipsticks, it would look a lot worse by this time. It didn't feather out. It dried really comfortably. It feels lighter weight than the Maybelline one that I mentioned earlier. And overall, as long as you don't stack this over and over, I think you'll be okay. So I touched up just kind of on the inner part of my lip. That faded down with what I was eating, which had more like liquid to it. It wasn't super oily or anything like that, but I did like lose just like the inner heart down to like the middle of the lip. I touched that up with just a little bit with the tip of the applicator and then just patted it in, did one of these. And it worked out. It looks pretty even. It didn't look patchy. I think if you do a whole another layer, that's gonna get uncomfortable. So touch up as needed. Very, very nice product. Definitely give it my stamp of approval. It is mask proof. I wore a light colored mask and there was no issue there. I don't think it's technically waterproof, but water doesn't bother it really at all. Like all these little stains on my hands are from earlier today, so it really doesn't like smudge it. I do think it does wear down. As you can see, like the definition of it does go away, but it didn't sink into my lines badly. If anything, it looks like a soft like matte moment, which is quite impressive because a lot of mattes aren't exactly comfortable or soft. So I give it my stamp of approval. If I had to give it a letter grade, I would say this is absolutely an A product, not an A plus, because you know there's still a little there's still a little rhyme or reason as far as application goes. There's like a little method to its madness. But if you were thinking about getting the new NYX Lip Lingerie XXL, I say go ahead and get it. I'm sure it's sold out like crazy because of all the TikToks. But there's a lot of different shades, and I got mine on Ulta. I reserved it on like the website for in-store pickup. So do with that information as you will. I hope you guys enjoyed. Our face actually still looks pretty good. I ended up putting like a little powder on my nose, and you know, my nose is gonna act up today. But otherwise, I think the contour worked out pretty well. Like the shade we worked with, not a bad product. I'm not sure it's like holy grail status, but it was not bad. The blush I think is a pass for me. I don't really love the color or the consistency on me, but it wasn't a bad product. It has faded after this amount of time, but at least it didn't break up on me. Before I let you guys go, just reminding you, if you want to save 50% off using code SAMAGE at theway.com, theouai.com, you can go ahead and do that. All the links will be down below. You can clickety click. My recent uploads will be on the screen right now, as well as the subscribe button. So if you want to check that out, feel free to do so. It's free 99. Just click it, join the fam, hang around for a bit. I'll catch you guys in a later video.